One of the main endocrine disrupting chemicals that we hear a lot about is BPA. And the best way that I know to describe endocrine disrupting chemicals is to say that we have like a receptor site on our in our body. And a chemical comes in, let's say we think it's estrogen. The body malfunctions because in fact it's not really estrogen, it's actually plastic. And it's an estrogen mimicker and it causes all sorts of havoc in the body. Here are 6 tips to avoid BPA in your home. Let's just take BPA, which is commonly found in polycarbonate plastic, which is that hard plastic. And so I'm going to go through a number of things in the house that you can substitute polycarbonate plastic for, a preferably non-plastic material altogether. I would suggest avoiding plastic for anything that you drink. Glass is very, very inert. That's my top choice for an alternative. The second choice would be stainless steel. That does leach a few things, but it's not nearly as bad as other materials. So again, I would go for glass. And that's why I'm so excited about this incredible baby bottle company that makes baby bottles that have a glass insert, so you know that your baby is only getting milk from the glass, but it's protected in a BPA-free plastic so that if it falls, it's not going to break and you don't have to worry about broken glass. It's a great product and we sell it on a True Find. And so here's another example of a water bottle. This is actually glass and I really love it because it is, I get my own filtered water from my own sink and put it in here. And then if I'm traveling for hot, especially for hot things, you know, I really like stainless steel. Don't go with aluminum because that can leach as well. So these are simple solutions. They're increasingly available in health food stores particularly. There's some really nice glass-based drinking bottles that are designed so that they don't break. One of the materials that you really want to avoid to reduce your exposure to BPA are canned goods because there's a lacquer that has BPA in it that is coating the inside of cans. And studies have shown that people who eat a lot of canned goods have really high BPA in their blood, which is really not what you want. There's some companies that are breaking new ground in terms of their canned materials, but again, I'm always worried about using any kind of plastic until all of the endocrine disrupting chemicals have been taken out, because one after the other they're being implicated. So I try to avoid canned goods at all costs, within perspective, but and I make my own beans, and it just couldn't be easier to just really come up with fresh food alternatives to canned goods. Another way to avoid plastic in general and BPA in specific is to avoid plastic in your food storage. And so even when you are storing water, I buy glass ball jars, I have glass containers, and I just make do. I figured out how to avoid any plastic in my food, because one of the things about plastic chemicals is that they particularly leach into hot, fatty foods, so the last thing you want to do is store cheese, for example, in plastic, which even though it comes that way from the grocery store, and you know, go on a picnic and have the plastic be really warm, because the cheese will absorb that plastic. So just go glass as much as you can. There are a lot of cool children's stainless steel lunch packages, for example, and I would just stainless steel or glass would be the way to go. Another place where a lot of hard plastic is found is in appliances. This is an example of where the place that holds the water is a very, very hard plastic. And so you don't want water held in this receptacle for any time at all. And so a solution is a French press for coffee. It's all glass. And glass is very inert and it doesn't release chemicals into the water. So just look for glass. Also, you know, my daughter went to college and everybody used the Brita filters, and that's a polycarbonate, or it's a hard plastic receptacle for the water after it drips through the filter. And so I got her a stainless steel carafe, and she would just put the filter part above the stainless steel, and that was a way for her to avoid getting the plastic chemicals in the water. And it was particularly important for her because she's of childbearing age, and you want to be very careful of not being exposed to too much plastic when you're young. So people ask me how I filter my water, and I just buy a filter at the department store, and because what I like about it is that the water goes through and I can collect it in glass and it doesn't go into a plastic receptacle. Another really important place to avoid BPA is actually in your mouth, and it's in your dental bonding. And so be sure to ask your dentist to find you an alternative to BPA dental bonding.